Hello, I'm Liz Duplessis, the Instructional Designer in Distance Education at Santa Rosa Junior College. In this video, Dr. Jennifer Carlin-Goldberg shows how she uses Canvas Commons to import sample course shells with free OpenStax content produced by and aligned with the California Community Colleges Online Education Initiative's course design standards. Jennifer also gives us a tour of her hybrid statistics class in Canvas and explains how she integrated the OpenStax content with her own materials, along with shared quizzes and YouTube videos designed to go with the OpenStax textbook. Let's get started. First, I'll tell you a little about Jennifer and about the free OpenStax textbook she uses. Jennifer grew up in Petaluma and earned an AA in mathematics from SRJC before completing a PhD at UC Santa Cruz. She has taught at SRJC as full-time faculty since 2012. In the 20 years since Jennifer was a student here, free online math tools have taken off, from Khan Academy to full e-textbooks. For her statistics class, she uses a free OpenStax textbook. OpenStax is a nonprofit-based at Rice University that creates peer-reviewed, openly licensed textbooks, which are available in free digital formats to students and for a low cost in print. Since it launched in 2012, OpenStax has produced 45 textbooks in math, science, social sciences, and humanities that are free for faculty to use as is or to download and modify. Starting in December 2017, Canvas users can use Commons to import OpenStax content that the California Community Colleges Online Education Initiative, or OEI, has embedded in Canvas course shells. Jennifer shows how she found her OpenStax book in Commons and then added other course content to create her modules.
In Commons, I searched for, you just search for OpenStax, and they're all right there, so... Right, and all of the OpenStax Canvas courses pop up. Right, and there's my statistics course, and so I downloaded this darling and imported it into my hybrid course.
When an OpenStax Canvas course is imported from Commons, it includes placeholder elements for a homepage and other content. Modules include embedded links to OpenStax pages and other resources, which you can edit, remove, or add to, as Jennifer describes.
All right, so in my hybrid course itself, it created all these lovely modules, and I mean, a bunch of stuff. Sample syllabi, it's actually all set up if you are creating an online course, and I removed a few things because mine is a hybrid, so half face-to-face and half online. One of the kinds of modules that it created were the readings, right? Chapter one readings for every chapter, and it had a bunch of sections from the book in here, and the sections that we cover I left in the module. The sections we don't cover, just removed them. I also put a chapter quiz for that chapter at the end of this module, and instruction and goals. I created that one up here, and I also inserted the video lecture because I found video lectures that went with the OpenStax books.
Next, Jennifer shows how she was able to use modules to pull together and sequence all of the course materials that students need in one place, with OpenStax pages and YouTube videos embedded in Canvas. She starts each of her modules with a page titled Instructions and Goals.
So this is a page that I created to give dates and expectations, things like that. I have a chapter example, examples and vocabulary file for all the chapters that go with my lectures. That's the stuff we get to do in class. So, watch the video, read the book, and then complete the quiz. And they need to do it by a certain date, right? And then the next page, all right, there's the video.
Jennifer found videos that align with the OpenStax textbook by searching YouTube using the keywords statistics, OpenStax, and the author's name. One of the videos she uses for Chapter 1 was created by the author of the OpenStax statistics book. To search for YouTube videos without leaving Canvas, create a page and click Edit. Select the Public Resources button and click on YouTube. Search using keywords and use the Embed button to add it to the page and save. Students can view the video within Canvas or go out to the YouTube website. These OpenStax pages are also embedded in the modules so that students can access the content within Canvas. If you use Commons to import the OEI OpenStax content, you won't need to add it yourself, but you can easily add an OpenStax page to a module by clicking the plus button, selecting External URL, and adding the URL for the OpenStax page that you select. Embedding content in Canvas makes the material easy for students to navigate. If students would like to go to the OpenStax website, a link to the full textbook online is included in the course navigation menu. It takes students outside of Canvas, where the OpenStax site offers options for viewing or downloading the book, which Jennifer encourages her students to do. However, to find additional teacher resources, Jennifer leaves this site and goes to the OpenStax homepage, designed for instructors, by typing the URL openstax.org in a browser.
This is the page I'm used to, and I go under subjects. All right, and for whatever subject you are looking for, there's mine. And these are all the books that are available. In this, you want to look at the details and resources. This is where you want to go. All right, so details and resources for statistics. All right, you will have everything available if you are logged in, if you have an account, so you want to create an account. There's the PowerPoint slides, which I did download, and I've been using mostly the images, embed the images in my own lectures, getting started guides, sample syllabi. You can actually get a copy of this for your Kindle, all right, or for or into iBooks. Technology. All right, there's a lot of different, online homework or programs that you can use that have a system that goes with, or a course that goes with the OpenStax book. I use WebAssign for one of my classes, and there's a student's getting started guide here. So,
and most of these require some sort of payment, like the WebAssign?
Yes, yeah. WebAssign is very close to $30. It's a little bit more than $30 per student, which compared to the $160 book that came with WebAssign I used previous to this, it's a big discount.
For an even better deal, and if you're willing to participate in a beta trial, check out OpenStax Tutor, which is now available for several subjects.
OpenStax is starting their own online homework system, $10 per student. It's amazing. They've only got it for a few courses, biology, physics, sociology, I know for sure. They want to do more, but they need to have instructors to, give these things a try.
If you'd like to explore OpenStax or another open educational resource, you may qualify for a $400 stipend as part of the SRJC Textbook Affordability Act program that Jennifer is coordinating. To learn more, go to taa.santarosa.edu. If you'd like to know more about free textbooks, check out the Spring 2018 PDA session, Imagining Zero Textbook Costs, co-presented by Jennifer and others. Also see my interview with Jennifer from fall 2017 about her favorite digital resources beyond OpenStax. And you can explore Jennifer's demo module in Canvas by going to All Courses and clicking Browse More Courses and searching Teaching Tips. Jennifer's Chapter 1 module is labeled Demo Module by Jennifer Carlin-Goldberg, Statistics. Thanks for watching!